Salsa, it's one of the fastest growing genres of dance, and it touches down in Atlanta, Georgia with the World Salsa Championships. Dancers from around the world compete in five different categories, and they include on one, on two, cabaret, same gender male, same gender female, and the incredible team division. 13 judges had the challenging task of deciding a winner among the best dancers in the world. It's amazing dancing action that will for sure captivate and motivate you. From the Atlanta Marriott Marquis, it's the World Salsa Championships, and all the action starts right now. Hello everybody, I'm Paul Higgins and welcome to the World Salsa Championships in Atlanta, Georgia at the Atlanta Marriott Marquis. By invitation only, some of the best dancers in the world will showcase their talents. To set the stage, here's Jason Molina and Sasha Rionda.
Welcome, my name is Jason Molina from Puerto Rico.
And I'm Sasha Rionda from Mexico City. Welcome to the World Salsa Championship.
You guys are in for a great treat. We have some of the best competitors from all the competitions around the world, and they're ready to show you their best stuff.
Absolutely amazing. Some of the categories that we will see tonight are on one, on two, cabaret, team, and also this year we have same gender. There is a big panel of judges, very experienced judges. So Jason, tell us, what are these judges looking for in these dancers?
Well, they're looking for technique, they're looking for timing, they're looking for the best salsa steps, the best salsa turns, and of course, the tricks, the dips, which obviously decorate all these choreographies.
And are impressive too, but they also want to keep it down to the core of
yes,
what salsa,
salsa
really is.
They want
about.
To see these dancers do their best salsa.
Okay, well, I can't wait. I am ready. Are you?
I am absolutely ready.
Okay, let's do it.
Estamos en competencia.
Let the competition begin.
And that is exactly what we'll do as day one of the competition got underway, with all teams performing in the semifinals of this World Salsa Championship Invitational. Backstage, the nerves were definitely present as the teams prepared for 2 minutes of their life that took months in training. The physicality, timing, the choreography, costumes are just some of the elements that make for the complete package when it comes to top professional dancers competing in an event of this caliber. Accustomed to high-end competition is the on-one couple of Eric Arena and Javier Campinas. Champions in their own right, they were still anxious prior to day one of the competition.
Tell us, how are you guys feeling tonight? How's the tension, the excitement? What's the level?
Right now, I'm really excited. I feel like with competitions like this, you have so much anxiety for so many months that when you finally get here, you're just kind of more relieved than anything just to get it out and be done, actually.
And it feels good competing against a lot of amazing, incredible dancers, too.
Well, the on-one couple started where they left off as they were in championship form, easily reaching the finals with a strong showing in the semifinals. Javier and Erica advance. As Jason and Sasha talked about, we have on hand an esteemed panel of judges, 13 as a matter of fact, that look at every aspect of each performance. They know exactly what they're looking for, and the slightest deviation in a routine can make all the difference in the world. Billy Fajardo is the head judge, and along with his wife, Katie, they have decades of experience and championships under their belt. Billy explains the very basics of what the judges are looking for in a routine.
Well, there's a criteria that we settled on, where I've spoken to a lot of the hierarchy in the salsa scene. So we came up with something referred to as timing, which is the actual rhythm of the dance, musicality, which is how musical you can be with the music. Right? Level difficulty, and that depends on whether it's tricks, dips, and drops, turn patterns, or even shines. But you have these five things. That's what we're looking at. It's that easy.
A couple in the semifinals representing the cabaret division that demonstrated all the judging elements that Billy described is Ricardo Vega and Karen Forcano. They were simply fantastic, really incredible to watch. Karen has so much power, and every single move they make is done with such finality, so spot on. They took the cabaret division by storm, and the crowd quickly became huge fans of this couple. You'll see their full routine later from the finals, but for now, we'll tease you with a startling and breathtaking close to their semifinal performance. If you haven't noticed by now, salsa dancers are in great shape and good looking. Does appearance matter? You better believe it, as Billy Fajardo provides some very candid insight.
I think it matters a great deal. I mean, if you really want to look at it, I mean, everyone would like to think, well, it doesn't really matter. Anyone can do it, and, you know, let's just wear any costume. No, it matters. How you look matters. You know, as a dancer, I know that, I mean, if I go to Broadway and I pay $100 or $150 to sit there, I don't want to see a fat dancer. You know what I mean? I don't want to see a dancer that's wearing some rags. No. So when I look at couples, I want them to be attractive, to be a great product. And that means work out, diet, don't hang out, don't drink, don't smoke, you know, do what you're supposed to do. And a lot of these dancers are doing that. They know if you want to go to the next level, that's the commitment you got to have. You know, so appearance, yeah, it matters. And some of them might not have it, and some of them really get upset because they don't have it. But it's competition. What are you going to do? You know, it is what it is.
We've already seen one couple with those qualities in Javier and Erica that have been dancing together for 4+ years. On the other end of that spectrum is Jesus Aponte and Jessica Quells. He's an established dancer with a long career in many elements of dance. And for Jessica, she's young, very good, has an amazing personality, and quite honestly, growing up as a young girl, looked up to her fellow Puerto Rican partner as a hero. Now she gets the opportunity to dance alongside him in a major competition, having been together for only just 5 short months.
I know him like when I start to dancing. He for me is a teacher. He for me is it's a big honor to dance with him. And he has a style different on me. And for me, it's a pleasure. It's it's a big honor dancing with him, because for me it's like, oh my God, I'm dancing with Jesus Aponte. From Puerto Rico, he is a biggest teach.
For Jesus and Jessica, they went into the semifinals with high hopes of advancing to the finals the following evening. But unfortunately, their score would not break into the top three. So their quest for a World Salsa Championship title would come to a conclusion in Atlanta this time around. With that said, they entertained us all and gained valuable competitive experience. When we come back, we'll break down the rest of the divisions, showcasing the incredible action from the teams as the finals will be set. This includes same gender with amazing talent from both male and female categories. We're just getting started at the World Salsa Championship in Atlanta, Georgia. Lots more to come. Stay with us.